May I just start by saying, what a week. From the West Coast to Kentucky to Washington, D.C., it's kind of been a nightmare. So I think we all need some music. Welcome to our fourth Blue Notes Music for Democracy Shindig, sponsored by Sister District Project of Mass Rhode Island. I'm Juliette, a volunteer and member of the Mass Rhode Island Steering Committee. And tonight we are so excited to welcome two musical geniuses, Mary-Kate O'Neill and Jill Sobule. You are in for such a treat. For those of you unfamiliar with Sister District Project, we are a national grassroots organization of 45,000 volunteers working to flip state legislatures from red to blue. This year we've raised $1 million for progressive state candidates. Mary-Kate and Jill are donating their time and talent to raise funds for three state House candidates, Ricky Unquira and Francesca Sesti Brown in Florida, and Brittany Rodas in Pennsylvania. And I think all three are here with us tonight. Hooray! And I will ask them to say hello in a moment. So, why do we care so much about states in general and Florida and Pennsylvania in particular? For one, redistricting is coming up after this election. Florida and Pennsylvania are both badly gerrymandered in favor of Republicans, and now is our last chance to get progressives into office so they have a voice in drawing state maps for the next 10 years that will more accurately represent the actual human beings living in the district. State laws also affect our daily lives in every way possible, especially now. State laws govern most police conduct. State laws enable voter protection or suppression. State laws help to protect freedom of speech or not. Just last Monday, Florida's Governor DeSantis proposed legislation cracking down on, quote, violent agitators, or as we know them, peaceful protesters, with vociferous support from Republican state legislators. State laws affect environmental policy, especially critical in Florida, which has been slammed by climate change. State laws dictate responses to COVID-19, and we've all seen how that's going under Florida's Republican trifecta. As for Pennsylvania, a few months ago, a GOP House representative kept his test results Democratic colleagues while continuing to show up for work until he was unmasked. And guess who's running against him? Our own candidate, Brittany Rodas, who is here. Brittany's response, which in normal times would not bear repeating, was, if elected, I won't threaten the health and safety of those I disagree with. I'll work with them to find solutions. Talk about that dark, radical socialism we keep hearing about. The way things are going with the Supreme Court, states may be our last bastion of civil rights protections. This is why we need more Democrats in state office. Finally, state-level campaigns often operate on a shoestring, meaning our contributions have a huge impact. Francesca, Ricky, and Brittany are all first-time candidates who need to get their names out there and, of course, have not been able to canvass in person. Every dollar counts, and we'll be periodically posting donation information in the chat section. Francesca, Ricky, and Brittany, would you like to each say a quick hello? How about Francesca, are you here?
I'm here. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Thank you so much, Michelle, Laura, Juliette, the whole team for putting these on. Patrick, I just, honestly, your support is amazing and needed. We need to make sure Florida hits better, makes better headlines than we've been right now. So we're working hard to make sure that happens. So I'm so excited for tonight, the amazing talent, to hear the amazing talent, because we need music for our souls lately. Mm-hmm. So I'm very excited. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Brittany, you want to say hello?
Yeah, definitely. Thank you guys so much for being here tonight. This is the second Blue Notes that I've been able to be a part of, and I had so much fun the first time. I'm so appreciative of you guys putting this on again. And I see a lot of new faces on this one, which is great. I really appreciate everything that Sister District has done for us so far. We were one of the first rounds of candidates to be endorsed. So I've had the pleasure of working with all the volunteers and the different groups that we work with since, probably March. And I can't tell you how much your early support has meant for us. It has gotten us the position that we're in now. So thank you so much for your time, for your financial contributions, for the amount of dials that you've made into my district, because we would not be here without you. And we're going to win this because you guys helped us and got us where we are. So thank you so much. I'm so excited to hear the music tonight. And I look forward to regrouping at the end and sharing some more stories about democracy.
Great, thank you. And Ricky, our resident dancer.
Hi, Mary Kay. Hi, Jill.
Hi,
everyone. Thank you so much for the opportunity again to be here. I love you all. You already know that. The smiles on your face make me feel even better. I just came in from canvassing, so excuse my horrible look. It's been very muggy, very humid down here in Miami. I know Francesca has been canvassing a lot today too. But now more than ever, right? You just mentioned Ron DeSantis's horrible trajectory. And just, was it yesterday or the day before, Francesca? He actually declared that the entire state was in phase three of reopening, and that any local government trying to mandate masks or social distancing or not opening 100% to all customers would be met with resistance from the state. And he also said that any local body trying to implement fines on people who are not wearing masks or social distancing would be void at the state level. That is our governor. That is what he does. This is a purple state. And Brittany, I'm sure, you know, you have horrible stories in Pennsylvania as well, because these two states are so important to Donald Trump's reelection that these Republicans have to do these things in order to make a semblance of everything is okay and everything is going okay, to be able to even have a glimpse at reelection. Thankfully, earlier today, as the New York Times has reported, Donald Trump's taxes have been unsealed, and we have seen just a glimpse of what it is that he's been hiding from the American people. And so hopefully all of these things help us win. But as you all know, as we know, these races at the bottom of the ticket in Pennsylvania, in Florida, matter so much more, because it's us talking to voters, social distanced canvassing, that's going to make the difference, that's going to bring out that extra number of voters to vote for the Democratic ticket to be able to win in these very purple states that make headlines, right? Pennsylvania is no stranger to big headlines in political battles, and neither is the state of Florida, and all of your help will be going towards helping us get there. And, you know, Francesca and I, we've been doing these with you all, and you've seen us grow as candidates. I've gotten a lot better at making these speeches just in having all of these different events. And so I appreciate you all. Jill, your smile. Mary Kate, I was in the same position you were listening to everyone else. And I appreciate you both for being here and doing this for us. Thank you so much. Thank you, Laura. Thank you, Michelle. Thank you, Lucy. Thank you to Barbara and the rest of the team for everything that you do for us.
And thank you, the three of you, for daring to step into the fray to make our country better. For the artist's sake tonight, we'll keep everyone on mute, but feel free to do the Zoom clap. You can also type in questions or comments in the chat section, and time permitting, the musicians and candidates will stick around afterward to chat. We will be recording and posting this event. And finally, please donate to our candidates and tip our musicians who need our support as well. Venmo links are behind me, and we'll also post the Venmo and PayPal links in the chat. Okay, let me shut up now and present Laura Vecchione, a phenomenal musician in her own right, who kicked off our Blue Note series and who is going to MC. Take it away, Laura.
Thank you so much, Juliet. I just need to say I'm so honored to be here in this company, Ricky, Francesca, Brittany, and all of the volunteers and the musicians. The word courage comes from the word core, the heart, and I really feel love from Ricky, from Francesca, from Brittany. You're doing everything for the right reasons. And and these musicians that we have tonight use their intellect and their heart and their sense of humor for the greater good. And I'm so happy to be able to introduce to you both artists. Our first artist for this evening is Jill Sobule. Jill is an award-winning artist with the ECR Music Group and has recorded a dozen albums tackling all kinds of issues, from shoplifting to the Christian right. She performed with Neil Young, Billy Bragg, Steve Earle, Cyndi Lauper, Tom Morello, Warren Zevon, and John Doe, and has shared billing with Don Henley, Joe Jackson, Warren Zevon, the influential LA punk band X, and Lloyd Cole and the Negatives. Equally impressive, she inducted Neil Diamond into the Songwriters Hall of Fame. And we're here in Boston, so that's a big deal for the Red Sox fans. You can catch her with SNL alum Julia Sweeney in their Jill and Julia show. Welcome, Jill. Thank you for being here.
Hello. Hi, everybody. Hey, Frida. Should I sing a song?
So go for it.
Okay, yeah. I'm going to sing a song. I warned I have a song that got me a lot of hate mail, but it has the F word in it. So maybe I know there's kids there. So should I just say, I just will say F instead of fuck. Remember the Garden of Eden before Eve hung out with that snake. You could walk down the street, not worry about thieves. All the kids could go trick-or-treating. Then those foreigners started coming in, like the Germans in 1790. Then the Irish arrived, the potato blight. Neighborhoods started changing. Life was better, we lived right. Life had a paler shade of white. When they say we want our America back, our America back, our America back. When they say we want our America back, well, what the F do they mean? Before there was Ellis Island and that statue we got from the French. Well, that horse still alerting with strangers she's flirting, inviting them into our beds. The guineas, the coolies, the wetbacks, the reds, the Jews, now those terrorists. And who let in the woman looks after my kids and the one who is cleaning my mess. Life was better, life was clean. Send them all back, including me. When they say we want our America back, our America back, our America back. When they say we want our America back, well, what the F do they mean? Before the gays had the agenda, before the slaves were free, before that man from Kenya, he took the presidency. Everyone sing it with me on mute, and you can use the whole word. One, two, three, one. When they say we want our America back, our America back. When they say we want our America back, well, what the F do they be? One more time, Ricky. When they say we want our America back, our America back, our America back. When they say we want our America back, well, what the F do they mean? He only played $750 in taxes in 2017. Oh, why does that make me so happy?
Woo! Oh, Jill, that was so cathartic. Thank you. Thank you so much. So, We're gonna go to Mary Kate, and I'd like to give her an introduction. But before I do that, Jill, can you tell us a little bit about what made you decide that you wanted to be involved tonight with Sister District?
Well, first of all my gigs are canceled for the last 5 years, so I might as well do some good. That's all I can say. And you know, we forget it's not just the you know, there's all these local races that are so important that we need. And I'm happy to put in all the time till November.
Thank you. Such a great song. So it's my pleasure to also introduce you to another incredible woman. Listen to this bio. Mary Kate O'Neill lives in New York, but she's actually a local from Hudson, Massachusetts. Mary Kate financed her acclaimed 2002 debut album with... Everybody take a guess what she financed it with while my script gets... Where did it go? Ah. She financed the 2002 album with approved pre-approved credit cards, and since then has recorded 6 albums, toured the world, and has songs featured in movies and television shows. She's also an accomplished longtime painter, and I encourage you to go to her website. I went, the paintings are beautiful. Go to Mary Kate O'Neill. com, and there's no apostrophe, and it's O'Neill, N-E-I-L. So she's an accomplished painter, and you can see the paintings there, as well as her music life on her website. And when she's not making art, she's fighting the bad guys as an attorney at the U.S. Department of Education's Office for Civil Rights. For real. Welcome, Mary Kate. That's amazing.
Woo! Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here.
This is my first Zoom experience.
Wow.
I know. It's kind of weird. So I'm going to do a song called Hudson, which is about my hometown, Hudson, Mass. Sort of.
Cars go splashing by me, lights pass streaming by, too much going on here. You fade in and out of my mind, and words fall like acid rain. Once there was more to say, pouring like a bucket full of gin to numb the state I'm in. I need to find a covered place. I didn't dress the pot today. I didn't listen to the weatherman. Another day without a plan. With the back roads and the main street rotary, but I know I'm never going back to Hudson, so won't you join me here in New York City?
Produced my first record, and she has this theory that right before you go into any recording, you should just write a song, like, you know, 5 minutes before you go into your session. And so that's the song I did, you know, I wrote right before with Jill. Jill, what are some of the ones you wrote right before you went in?
Trump never paid taxes. My brand new song. It's my brand new song. I just wrote it right before we went on. 2 seconds.
$704. $705. I don't want to underestimate.
Well, maybe I'll do another kind of. I'll do a kind of silly song. I wrote of COVID. All right. I went to the rally, I took all the kids. We wear our hats proudly, giving it to the libs. Went to church last Sunday, you know what I did? I hugged everybody, I'm giving it to the libs. I'm giving it to the East Coast, giving it to the West. Here we know in Idaho, we don't need no test. I tried hydroxy, blah, blah, blah. No, I'm not sick. Can't think of a better way. Giving it to the libs. I'm giving it to Hollywood, New York City, New Orleans. Have you got your government check yet? Mine I haven't seen. I went to the Hobby Lobby. I took all the kids. They touched everything inside, giving it to the libs. 3 weeks later, I woke up this morning, I could barely breathe. Mercury rising, 103. Now I'm in the ER, waiting for a bed. The nurse, she wears a garbage bag, the guy next to me is dead. I've given it to my cousin, my poor husband too, my niece with diabetes, and I'm giving it to you. I went to church this morning, and you know what I did? I got buried in my MAGA hat, giving it to the libs. I'm proud to be an American. I'm giving it to the libs.
Wow, I think I have a new favorite song. Jill, is that recorded?
You know what? I just did a little thing and a friend did a little, I'll give it to you. I've got a great little animated cartoon for it.
Great.
It's very sick. It's a very sick cartoon.
Makes a point.
Makes a point. Mary Kate, what are you going to play?
I don't have any COVID songs. I only have COVID paintings. I haven't done any COVID songs, so.
Your COVID paintings are great, though.
I did a portrait of Charles Nelson Reilly to cheer myself up. And I don't know why. It worked, though. I'm going to do Charlie Weaver next. Friends on a corner, once waited on for you. Is it 8th and 14th on every avenue that keeps me hanging on to you? 'Cause everywhere I go reminds me you're not here. Shadows of untold stories, I waited for you to care. This string's on my finger to remind me that you don't. Is it 8th and 14th or every avenue that keeps me hanging on to you? 'Cause you fill my dreams, but none of my days. trying, I turned another page. This solitary cube, it's more real than you. Is it 8th and 14th or every avenue that keeps me hanging?
Rolling, keep
every
going.
Every time I pass 8th and 14th, I think of that song. You know? Well, guys, I think it's time for a happy.
You know,
yes, go ahead, Laura.
Oh, we're gonna, you guys, we want to keep you going for like two more songs before our intermission because we're loving this.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm doing a really slow version of American Pie, so that's going to take over the whole thing. Now, here's a song. It's, you know, after I heard there's some town in Texas where there's some brain-eating bacteria, and then I'm in L.A. right now, and there's the earthquake. So here's a love song, a happy love song about the apocalypse. Tomorrow the ground may shake, like they said it was bound to happen one day, and the Hollywood sign will fall, the final call. Don't you fret and don't be blue, you had me and I had you. It was a good life. It was a good, good life. Tomorrow we could all be gone. When the Russian gangsters sell the bomb and the waves come roaring from the sea, 100-foot swells over Venice Beach. Don't be scared, take my hand. We'll swim into the promised land. It was a good life. It was a good, good life. Tomorrow a tiny virus might grow, and everyone, and it's not the cold, or a hole in the sky will open wide. The aliens land on the 105. If it comes to that, what can we do? You had me and I had you. It was a good life. It was a good, good life. Said boom, boom, crash, crash underneath the overpass. Burning buildings, flying glass. A good life on the day they stood still. We won't have to pay our bills. It's the mudslides down the hill. A good life. We won't have to make our beds. Bring out the booze and like I said, let's have a ball before we're dead. A good life. Let the pious rise above. We'll go down in our sweet love. It was a good, good. And let's sing, it is a good life. Everyone on mute. It is a good life. It is a good, good life. It is a good life. It is a good, good.
Woo!
Kate?
I thought I would do a song of a sort of shut-in celebration song called Away. Since you've been away, I haven't left this room. I bought a piano I can't play. Next opened a new cafe where everyone has some kind of tattoo. And every day I sit and try not to think of you. I lose myself for days in piles of clothes that I don't put away. I take blue pills from Georgia, Philadelphia, and pretty soon I think I can't live without you. And one day later than I planned it, I'll pine for moments to for granted. Now I find everything's a shade of gray. One day sooner than I planned it, I'll pine for moments to for granted. But now I find everything's a shade of watching candle pins for cash. This is all such a bore. I don't think you're ever coming back. I take blue pills from Georgia, Philadelphia, and one more time I think I can't live without you. And one day sooner than I planned it, I'll pine for moments so for granted. But now I find everything's a shade of gray.
Background parts.
Oh, on you.
So great. Mary Kate, I did not get to ask you, what was it that made you decide to come join us at Sister District this evening? What are the issues?
I just think, you know, everything we all can do for this election, we should be doing. I personally wrote, I'm not kidding, like I think a couple hundred get out the vote postcards to Texas and Florida.
Thank you.
And plus, I'm very good friends with Juliet. So there you go.
Thank you both. I mean, such incredible women, all of you. Thank you for everything that you're doing, and thank you for your work with civil rights outside of music.
Quite a time.
Yeah, thank you. So we're going to take a very short intermission where I just want to remind everyone to please, if you look at the chat, you can see the Venmo and the PayPal of our musicians, both Jill Sobule and Mary Kate O'Neill, and you can also see where to donate to our amazing candidates. I want to thank you all for being here. I see some friends and family, and I see some people like licking envelopes. I think they're writing, I think they're doing political things while they're watching. Okay, so don't forget to tip our musicians, and I'd like to mention an organization that we love and that needs our support. It's Voting While Black. In this age of voter suppression and police brutality against Black people, Voting While Black provides critical services. For example, the group helps people register to vote, compiles citizens' reports about voting issues, and asks elected officials to sign a pledge rejecting donations from the police union. We'll be emailing you a donation link after this event, and please be generous as you can. Thank you. So, Mary Kate and or Jill, I don't know who wants to go first. Do you want to talk a little bit about how you've been connecting musically with people through these quarantine times? Let's start with Jill.
Well, I've been doing a lot of Zoom shows and staged shows, but the most interesting thing, actually, it's been pretty amazing, is I have a kind of a one-woman show called F Word Seventh Grade, and it's F Seventh Grade, and it was supposed to be premiering at first at the Pittsburgh City Theater in May, and of course it couldn't happen, but 2 weeks ago, well, I went out there a month ago to quarantine, and with there's three other people on stage, and we did three nights of a drive-in show where people listened to it in their car, and I played for Toyotas and Fords, and it was really, and instead of clapping, it was honking and people putting on their lights, and it was, there was something really wonderful about it, and I'm getting used to it. I know everyone is really tired of Zoom sessions, but I think when it's music, you know, it always, like, you know, we add to it. So I think that I've gotten used to it. I've gotten used to be able to try to talk to people through Zoom and through other ways. And I like looking at what everybody has on their shelves. And I love how some people forget that they're not muted, and it's hysterical.
Yeah. Ricky has a question for you. Can you see it there in the chat box? He says, Jill, is the F word your favorite word?
No, it just happens to be in a bunch of, you know, it's very expressive.
It's a compelling word.
I only started using it this year and never in the rest of my life. But I just thought, well, the show Seventh Grade, what else are you going to say about it? Did anyone else, was that the, to me, that was the worst year of everyone's life except for maybe this year.
Right. Well said. Well
said. I'm dating myself. But seventh grade, for me, the only memory I have is I read the first Harry Potter book in seventh grade because that's when it came out. And it was the first book I read cover to back. And I just felt so accomplished having read a whole book. So that's the only memory I have in seventh grade.
And now you're making your own magic, Ricky.
Yes.
Saving the world.
How about you, Mary? Ricky and the rest of you guys, anything me or Mary Kay can do, if you need some songs, just get a hold of us.
Sorry, I had to unmute myself. I'll take you up on that.
Okay.
We're good at theme songs. Jill's probably better than I am. I had one that I did that I don't know why it never caught on. Remember the one for... oh God, what's the name of that? Slim Fast? Remember that one, Jill?
Yeah, the thing is they didn't ask you to write it. That was the great thing about it.
Well, I mean, if they had heard it, it would have been a smash. It would have been viral before there was an internet to be viral. Do you want me to do it?
Yes.
Slim Fast? How do you make that catchy?
I did a jingle for them.
Mary Kay, you did not. You made that up in your mind.
Well,
you're lying.
They never heard it, but if they did.
Okay.
I mean, you know, so this is how it goes. If you got teacher arms, if your hips look like your mom, try powder. All right, well, I knew that if there wasn't a mute, everybody would be just like screaming,
it's
like
true.
Hearing.
It's roaring with laughter.
Mary Kate. It's been a while since I've done it, so I don't know if I did it justice. But
a little Ethel Merman, did you notice in your presentation?
Well, that was what I was going for. That's what I was going for.
Yeah.
Ethel Merman.
What do we got now, guys?
I don't know. Why don't you use some, Jill?
Are we doing another song?
Who's up next? I think Jill is up next. Shall we have a song?
Let me ask you guys. I think I've outdone all my songs that are not depressing and sad. So let's see. I'm gonna Mary Kay. Oh, I've got one, and this is for all the progressive candidates out there. And the ones we don't think are, you know. Anyway, it's called Underdog Victorious.
Bobbitt Trucks was a fat little boy living in a shitty little town. And every recess, the dodgeball flew and knocked poor Bobbitt down. 4 o'clock when he got home, upstairs in his room, he closed the door, tie on his cape, put on his skin-tight suit, and he'd sing, Underdog Victorious. He was simply glorious. Someday he'll find notorious, Underdog Victorious. Years later, tried out for the Bandit Cubs of Matchbox 20, but he was dreaming of the New York Dolls and Max's Kansas City. Of course, they never called him back. They thought he was too queer. He didn't care. Back in his room, he sang unto the mirror, and he sang, Underdog Victorious. One of his great gifts, and one day all those dodgeball bullies would dream of his sweet kiss, and he'd sing. This is another lighter in the air kind of song. Underdog Victorious, he was simply glorious. Someday he'll die notorious. 1, 2, 3, 4. Victorious, we're all underdogs. He was simply glorious, simply glorious. Someday he'll find notorious, Underdog Victorious. All right, last time in a cappella, everyone. Underdog Victorious, we're all underdogs. He was simply glorious, simply glorious. Someday he'll find notorious, Underdog Victorious. Victorious, Underdog Victorious. Yeah! And the crowd goes crazy. That's right.
Yeah, baby. Woo!
All right, I'll do a depressing song about moving. Because I don't have any uplifting ones.
I'm ready for my luck to turn around. I'm off to buy a ticket today. I'm selling all I own in a yard sale. There'll be nothing left for me to break. I'll break the lease, toss in the hat. I made my bed, no turning back. 'Cause I'm ready for my luck to turn around. I'm driving myself to the West Coast. I always said I'd never live there. I'm shedding all the black in my wardrobe. I'm gonna brighten up my despair. With lighter hair and lighter heart, I'll soon forget we fell apart. 'Cause I'm ready for my luck to turn around. 'Cause I'm ready for my luck to turn around. Thank you.
All right, guys, can we have one more song from each of you? Do you think we can have one more song? And can I ask everybody to please make sure that they've tipped our amazing artists? All of their Venmo and PayPal is there in the chat right there. You've just been so great, and I've needed this evening. Thank you so much for being here. Jill, what do you have?
Let me think about it. Let me think. I know what I'm going to do. Here's a love song to New York City, actually. And a love song. If I had a jetpack, the first thing that I'd do is fly above the gridlock and come to you. I'd peek into the windows on Fifth Avenue to see how the other side lives. And if I had a jetpack, I would strap it on. I'd get out of this one room and I'd be gone to where there's real houses and big front yards. If I had a jetpack, I'd take you up with me. At last we'd both be free past the Statue of Liberty and my jetpack. If I had a jetpack, I'd fly above the bridge. I'd wave to all my friends who thought I'd never rise again. I'd fly over the stadium to watch my team win. Watch my team win. And if I had a jetpack, I'd walk into your door. Take you by the hand to the Jersey shore. And underneath the moonlight, you'd want me even more. Cause I'd have a jetpack. I'd take you up so high. If I dropped you, you would die. But I want you by my side in my jetpack. I don't have a jetpack. I don't even have a car. I just have this token and a head full of stars. I wish you didn't live uptown so far. Cause I don't have
shed.
Oh, thank you, Jill. Remember tokens? Subway tokens?
When I first moved to New York from Denver, I remember tokens. I thought they were so cool. And then all of a sudden they moved to these plastic.
I know. I was just carrying out my.
They're not as romantic.
No, they're not as romantic. I was clearing out my parents' house and I found like one of those really, really tiny tokens, Subway tokens from a really long time ago. I want to like put it on a necklace. That was so beautiful as someone who's a New Yorker. Thank you. So I think we have one last song from Mary Kate.
Mary Kate.
All right. Cause we played it before, but I'm so tired of our secret war. Could we call it a day? I'll say you got high score. I'm so tired of our secret war.
Well, Mary Kate O'Neill, Jill Sobule, thank you so much for being here. I feel really honored to be in your presence, and I'm so grateful for you for using your head, heart, and hands to make a difference. And I want to thank Juliet for putting us in touch, and thank all of the volunteers, and I want to thank everybody who spent their evening with us tonight. Musicians need our support now more than ever, and so thank you for your donations to our musicians and to our candidates and to our causes. Please remember to tip your musicians, and I'd like to introduce you now to Michelle Ottaviano, the Sister District Massachusetts and Rhode Island team, with a call to action.
Hey everyone. So wow, that was just so much fun. And we've had four of these now, and every time I sort of forget just how much it like makes you feel great by the end of the night. So Thank you, Jill and Mary Kate. I can't top that, but we do have really fun phone banking going on. Calling for our candidates is really about the best thing we can do right now. They really need us to talk to their voters and tell them their names and tell them to get out to vote. And we have phone banks happening 4 times every week, Monday morning, Wednesday afternoon, Thursday evening, Sunday afternoon. So believe it or not, these can be really uplifting in their own way. We connect to voters, we share stories, we have a lot of team spirit, and we have experienced volunteers who can get you started and help you learn the ropes. So if you haven't tried it before, please do think about it. If we can't convince you to call for us, we have another option, and that's to sponsor our callers. So we have a call-a-thon going on, and we have a team of callers who are making hundreds of calls every week. And with these state legislative races, a few votes can really make the difference in the end. And so if you wanna sponsor our callers, pledge 50 cents a dial or 75 dials or something, and that little bit really makes a difference. So you can do that. And then lastly, just keep your eye out. We'll have one more Blue Notes event before the season is over here. We're still working out the date and the details, but Laura will be back performing this time around. And yeah, that's what I've got to say. Thank you so much.
Thank you everyone for being here tonight. This was sublime and so badly needed. Thank you, Laura, for emceeing. Mary Kate and Jill for your phenomenal music. Thank you to our candidates, Ricky Unquiera, Francesca Sesti Brown, and Brittany Rodas. If you haven't already, please don't forget to donate to them. If you're able, contribute more. And please support our wonderful musicians. You can tip using the links in chat and visit their websites for more music and upcoming events. We will see you next time, and maybe the week before will have been better, but thank goodness we got to end it this way. Thank you so much.